Hi guys, this is Heather and I'm here with a Friday Reads video. And it's Friday and I'm so glad. This week started off on a little bit of a low note for me. I had like tinnitus type of a situation going on. It started Sunday and it didn't really stop until yesterday, which is Thursday. And yeah, Monday was the worst though. It was at a level that it was making me dizzy and making me nauseous, just having this roaring sound in my ears. This one was worse than this one. This one was just like massive, like somebody had a blowhorn just making this roaring sound come out of it nonstop. It was exhausting emotionally and mentally. But today I feel a lot better. On to the video, which is what I plan on reading this weekend. And yeah, so I have a couple of books that are new to me. And the first one is Shatter Me. I've been asking people on Twitter and Instagram and friends and family what book I should read out of, I think, The Night Circus, Shatter Me, and The Iron Daughter. And most people were telling me to read Shatter Me. So I'm going to go with this one. And this is by Dahari Mafi. This is pretty hyped up book right now. Everybody's talking about it. Everybody seems to be loving it. So I figured I will just go with this one for this weekend and try it out. And while I was waiting and getting feedback from people last night, I kind of was browsing Barnes & Noble and I found this book, The Storied Life of A.J. Fickrey, and this is a novel by Gabrielle Zevin. And I downloaded the free sample chapters, and I am finding it really, really interesting. It's basically about this guy, A.J. Fickrey, and he owns this, you know, small bookstore that's in this, like, Victorian type of house. And it's really small. He's like mainly the only employee there. He has a couple of like part-time employees or volunteer type of employees that work there, but it's mainly him. And it's kind of hard to explain, but it just seems really good. It's about a guy who loves reading, who owns this bookstore, and it's, I don't know, it's just, I've, like I said, the first few chapters that I downloaded were really super interesting, and I'm thinking about going ahead and buying it. I'm just trying to determine if I want to just download it on my Nook or if I want the physical copy, because it has sucked me in and I really, really want to finish this book. So that is probably something I'm going to dabble in this weekend as well. And on top of my The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss, which is I've been slowly, leisurely reading for the past week and a half or so. I am on chapter 21 right now, and I'm really enjoying it. And I'm really enjoying the pace that I'm allowing myself to take with this book. It's like I'm able to savor it. And it's just really interesting, and I'm just loving the characters that have been introduced so far. And yeah, so this is just an ongoing book that I'm just going to read, you know, a little bit every day or every other day, just, you know, at my leisure. And I'm just really enjoying it. It's just, I don't know, I find it really relaxing, you know, to just kind of curl up in the bed, read a few chapters, and then drop off to sleep. So that's kind of how I've been reading it so far. And yeah, and if you have been following me at all this past couple weeks, you know that I have been participating in a read-along that has been hosted by Lainey, and that's from Ginger Reads Lainey. I will leave a link to her channel in the description box. And the book she chose for this read-along was Dorothy Must Die by Danielle Page. And I finished that almost a week ago, and I just read right through that book super quick. And it was a little, there were some moments in there a little bit darker than what I had expected it to be. So I was kind of like, oh my god, did that just freaking happen? That's horrible. But it, I mean, I enjoyed it and liked it. But there's been talk about this, not just this book, but the company that is kind of behind that book. Full Fathom 5 is a book packaging company, and the dude behind it, his name is something Frey, his last name's Frey, he has had all kinds of controversy with one of his books that he written. He tried to pass it off as his story, like it was all truth, and it turned out to be like bogus, and he was just like conning people, and Oprah even slammed him for it because his book was on Oprah's book club. Anyways, she took it off, but she brought him back on, and she ripped him a new one, apparently. But anyways, he kind of laid low for a while, and then he has come back with this new company, and he's just really shady. He's like a con artist, and the fact that he's associated with this book just makes me feel like I don't want to finish this trilogy, because I feel like it's supporting him and his tactics and, you know, lining money in his pocket, and I just don't want to do that because he abuses or takes advantage of authors. He pays them very little. He's just really shady and underhanded and dirty, and apparently he's got $2 million for this upcoming book that's pretty much a straight ripoff of The Hunger Games. And I mean, $2 million, and this dude ain't doing nothing as far as I'm aware of, except he's just happens, that's just the way he has these contracts written up. I don't know. But anyways, I did enjoy reading this book, but based on principle, I just don't think I will be continuing on with the series. I will follow people who probably will continue to read the series and kind of keep up with what's happening that way, but I just can't financially support this guy. I just can't do it. But anyways, I will leave a couple of links to some blogs that explain Full Fathom 5 as a company and explain what book packaging is, because otherwise I will ramble on and on and on forever about it. But yeah, that's kind of been my week, and what my weekend is going to consist of is these books. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you've heard anything about this Full Fathom 5, you know, what is your opinion on it? Does it matter to you, or, you know, you don't really care? Or, you know, just let me know your thoughts and opinions on it. And if you're not, again, aware of what's going on, I will leave some links to some really informative blogs about it, and then you can come back and share your opinions on it if you want to. But anyways, please like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video, and have a great weekend. Bye!